Hi guys, this is Sumukh Prakash Pathak in front of you to represent the topic Trapdoors, Super Zapping, Trojan Horses and Logic Bombs in behalf of Sri Vaishnav Institute of Forensic Science. First of all, we have to understand what is trapdoors. Trapdoors are the bits of codes that are embedded in program by the programmer of the system to quickly gain the access. Programmer generally used trapdoors to enter the system when they update the system. But trapdoors also have some drawbacks that they can also used by the hackers. Hacker used trapdoors to enter the system without the permission of the system administrator. It is impossible to remove the trapdoors because they are in the form of code. So the only measure is that to delete or to format the whole system. Then the problems from the backdoors. A backdoors allow the perpetrator and any other people which he cares to share his secret to view and download data, run programs and even gain complete access to the system. Means a backdoor can provide access to the system without the permission of system administrator. Without permission of system administrator, there is a high possibility that the hacker or the perpetrator can steal the credit card numbers, download the secret business plans and other illegal activities. How to prevent backdoors? First, organize audit of computer and network for the presence of backdoors. The cyber auditors are the persons who are security consultants. With the consultancy of this type of persons, we can get rid of backdoors. Second is avoid free version security software. The free version security software were copied or taken from friends or other, but the used security softwares have the trapdoors which are installed when you installed the free version of security software. The removing of a backdoor is difficult from the difficult task. The only way is uninstall the running software and install the backdoor free version of software. Means the old version can be uninstalled which have the backdoors, and again install the backdoor free version of that software. Method of disabling backdoor trigger. Backdoor triggers are the key which are used by the backdoor user. Means the person who try to enter from backdoor use the backdoor triggers. If we disabled the backdoor triggers, the use of backdoor can be minimized. First method is power reset. The power reset technique prevents the untrusted units from detecting the time which a system administrator take, means the how long victim has been active. Then the second is data obfuscation. In data obfuscation, the hacker or the perpetrator can be confused that when the system is active, when the system is logged out. The technique of data obfuscation can encrypt input values to untrusted units to prevent them from receiving special codes, thus preventing them from recognizing database triggers. Third is sequence breaking. The sequence breaking technique can randomly show the action of the system administrator on the system, so the hacker or the perpetrator couldn't understand the sequence of events that can serve as a database triggers. Now next is super zapping. The super zapping tools are the tools which are used by the system administrator to gain access to his own system, but not from the normal routine system, but from the breaking open glass, that is in case of emergency, in many times the due to some malfunctioning the system couldn't give access to the authorized user even. So at that time super zapping tools are used, but super zapping tools also have some also problems, so detection of super zapping is important. The super zapping program or tool can only be searched when the system is used in at a regular basis. So for detection of super zapping, so the detection of super zapping is based on the concept that if a small change can be occur in the system, it can only be recognized if the system is opened at regular basis. Then the next point is the applied computer programs does not expect this kind of frauds. It is difficult to detect super zapping in a occasionally used computer system. The occasionally used computer system is the data in that type of system is not memorable in the system administrator's brain. So if it can occasionally used system, the files in that system is not memorable to the system administrator. So if small changes can be occur in the system administrator could not understand that. Avoid super zapping. Use your system at regular basis. Take help of software designers, then enforce capability checking at a runtime. The software designers have the capability to check the presence of super zapping at the runtime, means at the running stage the system administrator couldn't understand the super zap, but the software designer can be easily understand that. Then the inquiry programs without any purpose can be limited to read only. Inactivate program which obstruct with unauthorized access. For easy running of the system, inactivate the program which obstruct the unauthorized access, or if any person try to get unauthorized access, it can automatically inactivate it. Then the next topic is Trojan horses. Trojan horses are the hidden malicious computer programs which are attached with an application software or with an advertisement. When the system administrator give permission to installation of the software for application software, the Trojan horses also get permission to install on the system and start harming the system. The Trojan horses is based on the story of a Roman king. The kingdom of Roman king was well protected from the other kingdoms because they have a high security level. So the attacker planned to send a wooden horse in his kingdom, and the soldiers were put inside that horse. When horse enter the security crosses the security level, the soldiers from the wooden horse comes out and attack the kingdom. Same concept was run on the Trojan horses. How to prevent Trojan horses? There are some measures such as never execute a program from an untrusted source, do not open email from an unknown sender, at regular intervals update the antivirus, anti-spyware on your system, update latest version of the available on operating system before using scan every external storage device, avoid pre-version of software. these are the some measures which are used to prevent the Trojan horses. Then the last topic is logic bombs. The logic bombs are also known as slack code. They are inserted in the operating system or an application software that implement a malicious functions when it gets favorable conditions. They are not considered as viruses because the viruses are able to propagate themselves, but the logic bombs cannot propagate themselves, but they are used with viruses, bombs, Trojan horses, whose main intention is to cause maximum damage to the system. Then how to trace logical bombs? Logical bombs can be searched, can be traced by deep searching, means by deep searching we can trace the logical bombs, as the anti-malwares are not able to trace the logical bombs. So the main place where the logical bombs are found were the free version of software. The free version of software have maximum possibility of presence of logical bombs. Then the knowledge, the logical bomb can be detected by experienced auditor having vast knowledge of such type of problems, as they have experience from past. They solve many cases related to logical bombs. So if any logical bombs enters in the system, the knowledge of experienced person is used to treat or to delete or to remove the logical bombs. Thank you. If any question arises in your mind, ask me on the give section. Thank you.